tensions running high for the culmination of this great karting series here at the Clay Pigeon Raceway. This is the big final, the 10-lap Supernationals. We've had 5 attempts to start the race, and now the clerk of the course has stopped the warming-up lap and told the drivers to settle down a little bit because they want to get this race underway. It's going to be between the two men at the front. I don't think there's any doubt about that. That's Nort, Richard Weatherly. He's won 2 of the previous rounds going into the final. And number 12, David Duff. And they're away, safely away this time. And it's Weatherly leading into Billy's line. So Weatherly leads. I think it's Duff in second place. Is it Cuff in second place? No, it's not. It's number 30, Chapman, up into second place. Cuff third. But leading the way, Richard Weatherly. Weatherly leads. Number 33, Gary Chapman in second place, and David Cuff in third spot. Those are the 3 leaders on this first lap as they go round the loop up towards Pitts Bend. So Weatherly leads, second place Chapman, third place Cuff, fourth place O'Hara, fifth place Brogan. Down through the start area for the first time, approaching 80 miles an hour. Just a little dab on the brakes as they go into Billy's Blind for the second time. Weatherly leads, Chapman second, Cuff third. Up through the S's, over the finish line, 9 laps to go. They break for the hairpin. Weatherly still leads. A wealth of experience both in Britain and Europe. He's from Kent, as I said. He won 2 rounds of the qualifying. He also won the pre-final. And somebody goes off wide then. It looked like number 12, Cuff, has gone. No, it's Weatherly. Weatherly's gone. We've lost Weatherly then. He's gone off wide. So now Cuff leads in second place. We have that Weatherly is off and out of the race, we're told. Oh, what an upset for him. And there he is, the man that had dominated practice. It looks like he got into a tangle there with Jeremy Cottrell. But the man who dominated practice is out of the race. 8 laps to go. Cuff leads up into second place. It's number 11, Andrew O'Hara. And a bump there for O'Hara. Coming up into second place there now is number 2, Calder. And at 33, also off. The race has been stopped. The race has been stopped, the red flag being shown by the clerk of the course. I think that's probably concerning the incident that started with Richard Weatherly, but they're just 3 laps into this Supernational final and the race has been stopped.
Clerk of the course, Charlie Box, was the man who stopped the race, and he delivered a stern lecture for aggressive driving.
I will not tolerate stock car racing here. This is kart racing, nothing to do with stock racing. If you want to do that, forget kart racing, go and do it. Don't come here anymore. I expect proper racing, clean racing. I don't expect people just to go bowling each other off in that manner, and I will not have it.
Who was causing the problems there?
I think 50% of the drivers. I don't know why they do it. They just think they're something special. If they want to stop car racing, let them go and do it. But I will not tolerate that type of behaviour, especially on a day like this.
Well, this controversial Supernationals final eventually got underway again. And although racing was hard, the drivers had certainly cooled down somewhat after that roasting from Charlie Box. Nick Harris with the commentary.
Up through the S's, over the start line, over the finish line, sorry, 9 laps to go, up to the hairpin. Weatherly leading, number 12, Cuff just tucked him behind him. In third place, still Gary Chapman. Round the left-hand loop, up towards Pitts Bend. Weatherly, with a wealth of experience both in Britain and in Europe, he won 2 of the qualifying rounds. He also won the pre-race final. So, as I say, a wealth of experience at this level of competition. Cuff trying to get round the outside of it, failing. But it's still Weatherly leading. O'Hara in third place, mounting a charge on the Cuff. And in fourth place, Ashley Sinclair. Into Billy's Blind. Weatherly, Cuff, O'Hara and Sinclair. This is Weatherly and Cuff. And this is the view from the camera car, Lee Renison. You can just see how bumpy karting is, also how fast it is. Tremendous battle in the lead. This is the big final, the 10-lap Supernationals. Weatherly still leading. Cuff trying all he knows to get past him. In third place, O'Hara. In fourth place, Sinclair. And in fifth place, Steve Brogan. These 5 putting on a tremendous performance here at Clay Pigeon. Brogan trying to get up the inside of him now. No, he fails. It's still Weatherly. And Brogan's done it. Brogan's in the lead for the first time in this race. Sorry, Cuff's in the lead for the first time in this race. They go up through the S's, over the finish line, 7 laps to go. David Cuff now leads into the hairpin. Weatherly in second place, in third place O'Hara. Sinclair fourth and Steve Brogan fifth. They're now in the loop section and Cuff pulling away slightly from Weatherly. David Cuff from Northwood in Middlesex, again a man with a wealth of experience, a former British champion. He was second in the pre-final. That's Cuff leading. Second place, Redley. Third place, Von O'Hara. Fourth place, Sinclair. Fifth place, Steve Brogan. And Cuff's just put in a lap of 35.13. That's a speed of 51.24 miles per hour. They cross the finish line. Six laps to go into the hairpin. Cuff still leading. But a real chasing bunch behind him now. That consists of Weatherly. It consists of O'Hara. It consists now of Sinclair and of Brogan. These five putting on a tremendous performance, but Cuff pulling away slightly as they go around Pitts Bend, through the finish area, past that commentary box at 80 miles an hour. A little dab on the brakes as they go into the right-hander at Millie's line. David Cuff, number 12, leads. Safely through the right-hander, up into the S's. So Cuff leads, Weatherly second, coming under increasing pressure from O'Hara, Sinclair, Chapman and Brogan. For the hairpin, we've now got five laps to go, half distance for Cuff. £500 first prize, this Supernational final. He won one of the pre-qualifying rounds. Weatherly in second place won two of them, but Cuff's been saving his big charge perhaps for the final. He looks behind him, he can see Weatherly north, some 10, 15 yards behind. Number 11, Andrew O'Hara in third place. Through Billy's drive, up into the S's. They go right, then they go left, and then over the finish line, they look to see four laps to go to the hairpin. Brogan now up into fourth place. He's relegated Sinclair to fifth. That's the leader, Cuff, number 12. Behind him, Weatherly. In third place, O'Hara. Brogan fourth, Sinclair fifth. And Cuff really on the charge at the moment. They've got, what, 2.5 laps to go. The fastest section of the course past our commentary position. 80 miles an hour. 0 to 60, these 100cc Rotax carts will do in just 3 seconds. And Weatherly coming under increasing pressure from second place from Andrew O'Hara. But Cuff still leads, 2 laps to go. And O'Hara's now put in a lap of 35.2 seconds. That's 51.06. 51.06, a tremendous average speed round this 900-yard clay pigeon circuit. He's at the far end of the circuit now, Cuff. Round the right-hander, through the 80-mile-an-hour start area, past the commentary position, into the right-hander, and now Billy's blind. Safely negotiates Billy's blind. Weatherly still second, coming under more and more pressure from O'Hara. In fourth place, Steve Brogan, and in fifth place, Ashley Sinclair. 2 laps to go as they go up towards the hairpin. Cuff, Weatherly, O'Hara. And now we see that, in fact, Gary Chapman's up into fifth place. Steve Brogan still fourth, and Ashley Sinclair's been relegated to sixth. Cuff leads, a lap and a half to go. He must be thinking of that £500 and the trophy now. Weatherly fighting hard to hang on to second place. Cuff into Billy's blind. Just over a lap to go, up into the S's. The last lap board now being shown to David Cuff. 1.09 gap between first and second, so nearly 2 seconds between them. This is the last lap for David Cuff. He must be dreaming of that £500 now. No mistakes, hopefully, from the man from Northwood, the former British champion. He's an estate agent by trade. He was second in the pre-final, but no doubt about it now. He's on the charge. He's on his way towards the winning, the Supernational final. Through the start area for the very last time, 80 miles an hour, into Billy's blind for the last time. David Cuff on his way to victory. Cuff safely through the S's, the chequered flag being red, and David Cuff wins the Supernational final. In second place, Richard Weatherly. Third place, Andy O'Hara. Fourth place, Steve Brogan. And fifth place, Gary Chapman. But a win for the estate agent from Northwood in Middlesex. David Cuff wins the Supernational final and takes home £500.
David Cuff then our Supernationals champion. Richard Weatherly from London, runner-up. Andrew O'Hara of